Do you like math? Do you like following trails? Well, follow us on our math trail project around SDSU.
I'm Lauren, and today I'm going to be talking to you guys about three-dimensional shapes.
Hi, I'm Rachel, and I'm going to talk to you about rotational and reflection symmetry.
Hi, my name is Precious, and I'll be discussing why the triangles always add up to 180 degrees.
Hi, my name's Michelle, and I'll be going over what is scale factor and how do we apply it.
Hi, my name is Romnic, and I'm here to talk about the volume of prisms.
Hey guys, so for my part, I'm gonna be teaching you about three-dimensional polyhedra shapes. So right here we have a perfect example of that. It's gonna be a rectangle along this fence right here. And so these pillars have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up here, 6 down here, total faces. Then we're gonna talk about the total edges, which once again are gonna be along the sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 more up here that make a square, as well as 4 more down here that make a square. So you're gonna have 12 total edges. Then as far as lateral edges go, you're only gonna count these 4 along the sides right here. And then lastly, we're gonna talk about vertices. Now vertices are gonna be where all the points meet up together. So those are only gonna be up at the top right here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 4 more down here at the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, guys, so that concludes our little lesson on three-dimensional polyhedra shapes. Thanks for listening.
All these kinds of places make it seem like it's been ages.
Hey, it's Rachel, and I'm talking to you about rotational and reflection symmetry. So reflection, rotational, and symmetry are everywhere in nature, from the simple leaf to a plaque on a sign. So this is a rectangle, and it has 2 reflections, down the middle and across. And it has 2 rotational symmetry at 180 degrees and 360 degrees. That's it.
I love this country dearly. I can feel the ladder clearly. But I never thought I'd be alone to try. Once I was outside at the station, selling red and white carnations. We were still alone, my wife and I. Before we met, we saved our money.
Hi guys, so today we'll be discussing why triangles add up to 180 degrees. So over here we have a square. A square equals to 360 degrees. Now, where does the triangle come in? If you imagine cutting this in the middle, you get 2 different triangles. One triangle is 180, add that other 180, and you get 360 to make a square.
For a week or so at most, I should go on.
Hey guys, so we're gonna talk now about what a scale factor is. So before we do that, first we need to make sure that our angles of both of our shapes are the same. So we're gonna test that using our protractor. So as you can see, this one is 90 degrees. So by definition of a scale factor, this one should also be 90 degrees. And it is. Now, when dealing with scale factor, the only thing that really changes are the sides. So what's going to happen is we're going to take our original shape, and it's going to be divided by our new shape. So the formula defining scale factor is new over original. And once we do that, then we'll get the scale factor of the two shapes.
Take a walk.
I mentioned earlier that I would be telling you guys how to find the volume of a prism. Now, volume is the amount of space an object can occupy. Now, we can find volume by looking at, by multiplying length times width times height. And when we look at this object, this is going to be the length, this is the width, and this is the height. And we multiply those three in order to find volume. Hope you had fun on our math trail project. Hope to see you on the trail soon. I'm just too much a coward to admit when I'm in need.
My name is Precious, and I'll be discussing. Hi, my name is Precious, and I'll be discussing the sum of the triangles and how they add up.
That's it.
We cut the legs off of bands. We launch it into the ocean. Sit back and wait through the daylight.
Sit back and
wait through the daylight. Sit inside on subway grains.
It's kind of
get ready for our math trail project.
Let's go!